Uncle? I hope that was meant as a joke.
Well, it's not. Come, what is it that you want? Don't waste all day, nephew.
I only came to wish you a Merry Christmas, Uncle. Don't be upset.
How else should I be? Merry Christmas? Out with Merry Christmas. What's Christmas to you anyway but a time for paying bills when you don't have money and a time you find yourself a year older and not a penny richer?
Uncle.
Nephew, keep Christmas your way and let me keep it mine.
But you don't celebrate it.
Leave it alone. Well, what good has it ever done you?
There are many things that I might have found joy where I have not received anything, Christmas among the rest. Even though it has never put gold in my pocket, I believe it will do me good and will continue to. God bless it.
Bah!
Don't be angry. Come, eat dinner with us tomorrow.
I'll dine alone, thank you.
Alone? But no one should spend the season alone.
I would rather be alone!
I'm sorry that you choose to be alone, but know that our house is open to you. And that Christmas is a time to spend with loved ones and to remember the gift of salvation that he gave to us.
Good afternoon!
And a happy new year. Jesus, my uncle is a hard man who needs love. Show him your love. Open his eyes. Give him the gift of love, peace, and joy. Amen.
Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen,
Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen.
But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all?
Sir, do you have any change to spare? Please, I haven't eaten in days, and I don't have enough money to go home to my family in this holiday season. Please.
Get away from me, you beggar! I work hard for every penny that I earn. Why should I waste any of it on a person that doesn't even work and you stink?
Easter, today is a day of love as we celebrate our Savior's birth, and you can't spare a little change for someone in desperate need. I pray that God will touch your heart that has grown so cold and removes the scales from your eyes so that you may see how miserable your life has become without him in your heart.
Bah, humbug!
As Scrooge settled into bed on this cold Christmas Eve night, he began to ponder on his encounter with the man on the street. Had he really been missing out on anything since he had strayed away from God? Little did he know, his life would change forever with what was to come later that night.
Marley! Is that you? Why have you come here?
Yes, it's me. I'm here to see what I can't have, and I wouldn't share when I was alive.
Why do you seek what you can't have? Why do you wear those chains?
The chains? Look at it, Ebenezer. Locks and bolts and golden coins. I made them over the many years that I worked. Greed, Ebenezer Scrooge, wealth. Fill them. Know them. For the way you're going, yours will be even more.
If you came here to lecture me, I have no time for it. It's late, and I want my comfort now.
I can't give you comfort but a chance. I've been around you for many years. You see what comes from the way we live. Listen to me.
Leave me.
You will be visited 3 times tonight. So pay attention to your guests.
I don't want to.
Then you will walk where I do, burdened by your riches and your greed.
I make my own way, and I lead my own life. How can somebody come in here and give me a chance? Leave me alone already!
Expect the first when the clock strikes one. Then they will keep coming throughout the night. Remember what was spoken between us tonight. Remember!
Jacob! Jacob Marley! Don't leave me!
As the bells started to toll, they awoke Scrooge. The spirit of Christmas past was approaching.
Are you the guest Marley told me about?
I am.
What are you?
The past.
The past? What do you mean the past? How far in the past?
Your past. I have something to show you. Get up and come with me.
I am human, and I can't go where you go.
Grab my hand.
Everyone was home for the holidays, cozy and having fun in the town except one. Here sat Scrooge alone with a book. Kind of odd for this season, but let us take a look.
What is the young boy reading?
Oh, that? That? That's nothing but nonsense!
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Yeah, it's all make-believe!
If you love me, please show me. Please change everything. Christmas, why can't I find you? Why have you gone away? My world is changing, I'm rearranging. Does that mean Christmas changes too? Where are you, Christmas? so carefully. Now nothing's easy. Did Christmas change or just me?
Spirit, my old friend. I remember him. If he really cared for us, then why? Oh, never mind. He'll be all right. He'll grow out of it. Yes, he does grow out of it. The nonsense. He left there and became a man, a successful, rich man.
Fam!
I've come to bring you home for good. Come on.
Wait, let me watch them go. Let them be happy for a moment.
She dies a woman and had children.
Just one?
Your nephew.
Yes. Fred, my nephew. Well, we all have those, haven't we? Childhoods, sadness. But we've grown and become men, masters of ourselves. I have had enough of this Christmas nonsense. I have learned what you have come to show me.
Poor old Scrooge was hurt and lonely as a young boy with no guidance. Most of his years spent reading the Bible, but not understanding the fullness of God's love. Eventually, he gave up. As a boy, he turned to a toy for comfort, but as he grew older, he would go on to search for something only God could fill. He went a different way, turning to work and money to fill his life, which in turn only gave him a greedy and empty heart. The first spirit took him and reminded him of many other events in his life where things could have gone differently had he held on to his faith. Scrooge lost the love of his life because he was so caught up in building his success that he neglected the love that was in front of him. They also remembered the day his partner Marley had passed away. Scrooge's main worry was about taking care of his affairs and nothing more. The first spirit took him to remember the past to steer him in the right direction for his present. But we will get into that in a moment.
My time here is coming to an end. I must leave you now.
Not yet. What must I do? And what about all the other spirits?
They will come. Now you must reflect on what I have reminded you of on this night.
The clock struck one, and we've just begun. Here comes the second visitor of the night for Ebenezer Scrooge. This guest comes with a lesson to be learned, hoping to turn the heart, open the eyes, and change a life. Here goes another try.
Scrooge, I am the ghost of Christmas present.
But
now, Scrooge, you'll see what you'll see. Will you take a walk with me this Christmas Eve?
But I am not dressed.
Nonsense, Scrooge. You won't need clothes where you're going. Come.
But wait.
What is it now, Scrooge?
Christmas present, did you say?
Indeed, Scrooge.
Then where are you taking me?
Why? None other than Bob Cratchit's house.
My clerks?
Yes. Oh, you didn't want to speak with him. Don't worry, you won't have to.
As they entered the household, Mrs. Cratchit began to put their son, Tiny Tim, to sleep. This little boy was a true reflection of God's love. Even though he was very ill, he remained confident, hoping that his story would strengthen others' faith around him and that his illness would remind people that God still does miracles.
So, how did our little Tiny Tim behave?
As good as gold and better. He told me coming home that he hoped the people saw him at church because he was a cripple, and he thought it'd be a pleasant reminder on Christmas Day who made the lame walk and the blind see.
He's such a good boy.
My dear, to Mr. Scrooge, the founder of this feast.
I wish I had him here. I'd give him a piece of my mind to feast upon and hope he'd have a good appetite for it.
My dear, it's Christmas Eve.
It should be Christmas Eve. When one drinks to the health of such a stingy, hard, unfeeling man as Mr. Scrooge. You know he is, Robert. Nobody knows it better than you, poor dear.
I only know one thing on Christmas Day, that we should share the love of Jesus on a day that's all about him.
You're right. I'll cheer for the hopes of his salvation, that God would pour his love on him just as he does us. Merry Christmas, dear.
Spirit, I have seen enough. Tiny Tim, does he live?
He's very ill, Scrooge.
I didn't realize he was that sick.
It's because you've become so narrow-minded, Scrooge. So concerned with your own affairs. So selfish with your own way of living. That you've neglected the needs of others. Why, you're so worthless and less fit to live the life you live than millions of other children like this poor man's boy.
Is there no happiness in Christmas present?
There is, Scrooge.
Take me there.
It's in the house of your nephew.
No!
Then there's nothing else to see, Scrooge.
But that can't be it. You must teach me.
Would you even listen to a teacher, Scrooge?
But the first spirit gave me more.
That was Christmas past. This is Christmas present. I don't have much time. I have now, tonight, and that's it. And even now, my job is almost complete. Come.
Is this the last one that is to come?
They are not Scrooge, but they are real. Hunger and ignorance. They roam your streets. They walk your alleys. But you deny them, Scrooge. Deny them not much longer, for they will grow and multiply.
Have they no place to go? No resources for help?
Are there no prisons, Scrooge? Or workhouses? Or brothels? Come, it's Christmas Eve.
cold. The heart longs for a little bit of hope. Oh come, Emmanuel. A child prays for peace on earth, and she's calling now from a sea of hurt. Oh come, Emmanuel. And can you hear the angels singing, glory to the light of the world, glory, the light of the world is here. A child breaks with the tears of a mother. A baby's cry is the sound of a love. Come down, Emmanuel. Glow, song for the suffering. Here's the song of the Prince of Peace has come. He has come.
Approaching the end, the third and final spirit has come to meet Scrooge. Let's see what the future has in store for Ebenezer if he chooses to continue down the path that he is on.
Are you the third? The spirit of Christmas future? Speak to me! Tell me, what has to happen to me? To all of us! Spirit! then show me. Show me what I am to see. Spirit, I know that place. All too well. It's cold. It's cheerless. It is mine. It's my place. Spirit, there are thieves in there. Spirit, there are thieves in my room. Spirit, I can't just watch and do nothing. I will not. It's still mine.
The poor old guy barely passed, and you guys are thieving his household?
Well, what do you expect us to do with all of his stuff? Besides, I heard the only one that showed up to his funeral was his nephew. I don't think anyone's going to care what we do with his belongings. Besides, everyone will be much more happy now that we don't have to tiptoe around him.
Come on, there's much to go around. He never took care of us anyway.
Do you think this bell he always rang at me is silver enough to sell?
No more! No more, Spirit! I can't take this anymore! Take me somewhere else! Anywhere!
My dear, you won't guess who I ran into today. Mr. Scrooge's nephew, Fred. He told me how nobody showed up to his uncle's funeral, but one thing he mentioned that really stuck with me is that time after time, his uncle had many opportunities to give his life to God, but he never did. He had a chance at having a family, but money meant more to him than anything in the world.
We have truly been blessed to know God and to have love and a family.
Yeah, I just wish there was more we could have done to let him know there's always a better way to live life.
You have such a big heart. That man was nothing but careless and greedy, yet you still wished him a good life. Our only worry should be that we show our children the right way, that we reflect who Jesus is, so they'll desire to have their own relationship with him.
Yeah, you're right. At least we can say before Tiny Tim parted with us that we taught him everything we could. That kid really was a light. All he wanted to do was share his love with others.
He died? You can't tell me that he died. Christmas hasn't come yet. I will not let it come. I will be there. Spirit, hear me. I am not that man that I was. I will not be that man that I was for so long. Why show me all these things if I am past hope? Assure me that I can change these shadows that you have shown me. Let the boy live, and I will honor God in my heart on Christmas and all year, in the present and the future. I will not shut out the shadows. I will not shut it out. All the lessons, all three spirits have shown me tonight. Spirit, tell me that it's not too late. Tell me it's not too late.
Finally, Scrooge cracked. All the lessons that were taught to him this night had gotten through his hardened heart. He had begun to realize that there was more to life than working and earning material possessions. Now we will see him back in his bedroom. Let's see what changes he will make.
Wow. What a night. God must be real. I got it. The answer. The answer is prayer. The answer is forgiveness. That's the answer. God, if you're listening, God, if you're listening, I'm sorry that I gave up on you so fast. God, I was lost as a young boy. I only found myself wandering deeper and deeper. But now I know it's time that I surrender my life into your hands. God, I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. God, I don't want to be a burden to the people, but a blessing and a joy to be around. God, this road that I've been on has been lonely, God. God, forgive me, God. God, I know I need you. I need you, God. Amen. Keep seeing it, children. Keep seeing it. Guess why? Because Jesus changed my life. Keep singing. It's Christmas. Keep singing, children. Sing, sing, sing,
when
children.
Right
sing, ladies.
Right
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Away.
Keep singing. Jesus changed my life. Jesus changed my life. Morning, hallelujah. How many enjoyed it? Let's give it up for the cast. Amen, hallelujah. They work hard all months, amen, to bring this live stage drama. What a powerful message, though. Powerful message of an individual that was filled with greed, self-ambitions, right, bitterness. And the Bible reads in the book of Matthew chapter 8, verse 36, it says, for what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? And in this world that we live in today, we always intend to try to live our own life and try to gain things that are called material stuff and try to improve ourselves in our lives. There's nothing wrong with that, but when we replace it, we replace God with those things, it's the thing that becomes dangerous. Because God is the reason. Regardless what lifestyle you might live, amen, the Bible talks about in the book of Acts, salvation comes through Jesus Christ. No name is given above the name of Jesus Christ. And we're looking for salvation. Jesus came and was born, a birth, amen, as a human being, as a baby, for our salvation, for our reconciliation with God. And during the season of Christmas and the jingle bells and the music and the going to the mall and the noises and the spending, we forget the reason for the season, and that is Jesus Christ. I can say I'm guilty at that times. Come on now. Let's be honest. We forget, amen, we forget about Jesus, but we were reminded about Dia and Theo and Mom and Dad, which is okay, but usually we put God at the bottom of the list. But what profits a man, the Bible says, to gain the whole world but lose his soul, right? And the Bible talks about exchange. Talks about in the same scripture, I'm not going to read, but talks about exchanging your soul for a price. And we know that Jesus died for us on the cross so we can live an abundant life. God didn't create us so we could be harmed or go through our things. Sometimes we are self-afflicted. In other words, we hurt ourselves. Can I get an amen? And sometimes we give the devil a lot of credit. When it's actually ourselves that we create those things within our lives. When God gives us what? The ability to just serve God and love God. And as you saw the drama, you see that a man was bitter. And I don't know, but some of us can identify with that guy. Especially on Christmas. Right? Some you probably have an uncle called Scrooge. Hello, somebody. Or an uncle. Right? But the key here this morning, or what I want to drive to you this morning, that you don't have to go through those things if you give your life to the Lord. And if you realize this morning that God is the true salvation and the power of God. And we can live a better life. But like I said, sometimes we're self-afflicted. We just live our own ways. We do it to ourselves. I'll make it happen my way. Amen.
I'll make it happen my way. And it's when we give our lives to the Lord and we surrender. And we don't build our own kingdom, but we build the kingdom of God. It's when true happiness comes to our lives. We're testimony of that. I'm a testimony of that. The cast is testimony of the power of God. The leadership here is a testimony that when we surrender our God to God, that God makes us, makes our crooked path straight. Can I get an amen? The old has passed away. There's a new creature, the Bible says in the book of Corinthians. All things have passed away, and we're created new. Say new. We don't live the same way that we used to live. We don't think the same way that we used to think. We don't talk the same way that we used to talk. Can I get an amen? Because God lives in us. And because God lives in us, we're changed by the power of God. Because if it wasn't for Jesus Christ, I wouldn't be right here standing today. Can I get an amen? If it wasn't for God, I wouldn't be here. This is not my choice. But I chose God. Can I get an amen? Living a life of misery, living a life running rapid, being lost, being bound. Bound to what? To drug addiction, bound to crime, manipulating, being deceived, living the style of the world, running around, creating chaos, creating headache, having my family worry about me. Can I get an amen? Having a crying mom worry about me. Because I lived a selfish life. I lived it to myself. But it's even to one day. I didn't get visited by three ghosts. I got visited by the Holy Ghost. Can I get an amen? And when the Holy Ghost comes in, intervenes, amen, he begins to change somebody's life just like myself. Can I get an amen? A man that was bitter, a man that had no love for no man, nobody, hallelujah. I was selfless. I was independent, and I knew how to hate people. Can I get an amen? Can I get a witness? Don't look at me like you've never been there. You're looking at me like, that's not me, bro. Hello. Right? And I always thought that people was trying to just run me over. Can I get an amen? Or do me a good one. But it's until I got visited by the Holy Spirit. That I was able to give my life to God and surrender my life in 1994. A miserable life. A life of hate. A life that I didn't even know that I was going to even be living the next day. The life that I was living, I didn't think I was going to live past 14 years old. The life that I was living, I didn't think I was going to pass 15, 16, 17, or 18. Can I get an amen? Why? Because the life that we live in the world, it's a fast, rapid life of crime and hate. Are you with me? But by the grace of God, I'm standing here 53 years later. Can I get an amen? Serving God. And why? Because I surrendered to God. And I said, enough is enough. I need a new life. I need a new change. And I gave my life to God this that day. Never been the same. God restored it. So this morning, I want to give you a chance to do the same thing before you go home. I want to give you a chance to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior this morning. It's an invitation for a new life. It's an invitation that God is going to change your life if you say, I want to accept God in my life. That's the only thing you have to do is accept the invitation. But also you can reject it this morning as well. So as everybody's praying this morning, those saints, those, the cast that can come and help me out, hallelujah. If you're part of the cast, come help me out. But if that's you this morning, you need Jesus in your life. And you came here just to be entertained, but it's a setup from the Holy Spirit this morning. You're tired, being tired. I'm going to invite you to accept Jesus Christ this morning. And the only thing you have to do is just lift your hands. If that's you this morning, I want to give my life to the Lord. Lift your hands right there where you're at. I see your hand. Come on, don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed of Jesus. Amen. I see your hand, my brother. I see your hand. Come on, everybody praying. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, let's sing a song. Oh, hallelujah. Go ahead. Now, if you lift your hands this morning, I'm going to ask you one thing. The leader's watching right there. Hallelujah. Come on. Come to this altar this morning. Hallelujah. If you lift your hands, we're going to ask the leaders to go and reach out to them, bring them to the altar. Leaders, come on. If you lift, come on. Women, where the ladies at? We need some leaders. Hallelujah. Well, the ladies right here. Ladies, you're part of this church. Come on. We have some souls right now. Come on.
It's your grace.
Right there.
It's your wonderful, incredible embrace.
Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord.
It's your love.
Right there. Somebody right here. Come on.
It's your grace.
You guys go down there.
It's your wonderful, incredible embrace.
Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, guys. Oh, hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Come on. Sister Lupe. Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Oh, hallelujah, Lord. I want. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, hallelujah, Lord.
It's your grace. It's your wonderful, incredible embrace.
Yes, Lord.
It's your love.
Oh, hallelujah, Lord.
It's your grace.
Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. What we're going to do this morning. If you're giving your life to the Lord this morning, I want you to repeat with me this morning this prayer. And this prayer is a prayer of accepting God in your life. Simple prayer. And I need you to repeat with me this morning. So if you're giving your life to the Lord this morning, I need you to repeat that prayer with me this morning. I need somebody behind this young man right here. Please, come on, guys. Right there. Right behind that. Thank you. Thank you. Just repeat this prayer with me. We want to make sure that we're praying for these individuals that are giving their life. It's important. It's important that we stand in the gap this morning with that family right there. This is important this morning. So I want to make sure that right here, Sister Adriana, you got somebody? Right here. Right there, sister right there. Oh, you got her? All right, cool. Thank you. All right. Amen. Over here, we got sister up there. Myra. All right, you got her. Come on, family. In unity. We're going to stand in the gap this morning. So that person that's praying for you this morning belongs to Victory Outreach. We're here as a family. Amen. And we're going to say this prayer this morning. So once I'm done with this prayer, I need you to connect with that individual. Get the information. Amen. Because we want to make sure. Listen. This is not just accepting God, but we want to make sure that we are able to guide you through this journey of faith. And we're here. We're here to guide you with that. We're here to help you out. So that person right next to you or who's praying for you, amen. It's going to be your person that's going to connect with you. So repeat this prayer with me this morning. Jesus, Albert, Jesus, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Forgive my sins, and I accept you. Devil, I reject you in the name of Jesus. No longer do I belong to the world, but I belong to my Savior, my Master, Jesus Christ. Jesus, I love you. I accept you. I embrace you. I welcome you in my life. Change me. Change me in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The Bible says that if you say that prayer for the first time, the angels in heaven are celebrating in your name. They're throwing a party in your name because that's how much you're important in his eyes. Jesus loves you very much. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. That he died for you on the cross. And we're going to come and pray. So that person that prayed, I don't want you to go, guys. Leaders in the church, that's your person right there that you pray for. Connect with them. Don't leave. Connect. They need help through this journey. We can help them. Amen. Father God, we come before you in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will seal this message. Seal the message, Father God, of salvation, restoration. And I pray right now, Father God, that those that gave their life to you, Father God, that they will feel the power of the Holy Spirit in their lives and change that can be changed through you, Father God. You're able to do it in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray and we say amen and amen. Come on, let's give it up for Jesus this morning. Hallelujah.